Sing with me. Say, Lord.
Lord.
I love you.
I love you.
I thank you.
I thank you.
For being my God.
For being my God.
The God of Jacob.
The God of Jacob.
The God of Hezekiah.
The God of Hezekiah.
The God of Isaac.
The God of Isaac.
The God of Melchizedek.
The God of Melchizedek.
The God of Elijah.
The God of Elijah.
You are hearing my cry in this place today.
You are hearing my cry in this place today.
In the name of Jesus.
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 Say, Father, in the name of Jesus.
Father, in the name of Jesus.
I thank you.
I thank you.
For remembering me every day.
For remembering me every
day. For remembering me every season.
For remembering me every season.
Start to pray, thanking God for remembering you. Begin to pray, my God, in the name of Jesus.
Jehovah, Father,
I thank you. I honor your name in the name of Jesus.
For your anointing, for your special blessing, Jehovah.
For
Father, I know that I have a special blessing in your hearts, Jehovah. I know that I have a special blessing in your hearts, Jehovah. Father, though I may disappoint you time and again, Jehovah. Father, I disappoint you time and again, Jehovah. But you remain faithful because you are God. You remain loving because you are God. Father, you remain blessing my life and forgiving me because you are God. The one without shadows, the one that does not get moved by men, Jehovah. Father, Murimari, Jehovah. You are who you are because that's what you are, Jehovah. Father, today we worship your name, Jehovah. Father, as I pray today, Jehovah. Father, we pray, Almighty God, for your spirit to move, Jehovah. May your spirit move in this place without limitation, Jehovah. Father, may your spirit touch lives today, Jehovah. Father, we pray, Jehovah, in the abundance of your love, in the abundance of the spirit of repentance, Jehovah, Jehovah. Father, as we pray today, Jehovah, may you touch our lives, may you touch our hearts today, Jehovah. May you touch our hearts to repent from each and every evil that we do. Father, as we pray, Jehovah, may you touch our ears today. May you touch our ears today, Almighty God. May our ears be open. Open to hear your voice. Open to obey whatever your commands are. Father, as we pray today, Jehovah, Father, we repent whatever spirit of deafness, Almighty God. Whatever spirit of ignorance of the word, Jehovah, Father, that which your word says, let us be found true. That which your word commands, let us be found true. For we know that you are the Almighty God. Whenever you say yes, no one can say no. Whenever you say no, no one can say yes. Father, as I pray today, Jehovah, Father, we declare and decree the prevalence of the word, Jehovah. Father, as I pray today, Jehovah, Father, as the word is being used today, Jehovah. Father, my party is for some more in Jehovah. God, my table, Ralu. God, who's a good day, Oka. God, who's a shadow of Jehovah. Father, as we pray today, Jehovah. Father, as we pray today, Jehovah, Almighty God. Father, we pray to the spirit of repentance, Jehovah. Father, may we remember your best.
Whenever you are, I pray for your blessing.
You know for God that worship you in the truth and in the spirit.
In the name
Father,
of Jesus,
pray, let us not pray by prayer words alone, but let our spirits worship your name. Let our hearts worship your name, Jehovah, with every power of our lives, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Father, as you pray today, Jehovah, Father, as you pray today, Jehovah, whatever that is said, let us mean it with every inch of our hearts, with every inch of our souls, with every inch of our spirit, in the truth and in the spirit, Jehovah. Father, as we pray, Jehovah, Father, we know that you're moving into a new season, Jehovah, a new season that you've set apart for us, Jehovah, that you've set apart for us, Jehovah,
in the
mighty name of Jesus Christ. Father, as we pray, Jehovah,
thank you, Lord, thank you, Jesus.
You are holy, you are holy. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Can you greet the next person to you? Can you greet the next person to you? And tell them that you are fearfully and wonderfully made.
Say, neighbor, you are fearfully and wonderfully made.
Neighbor, you are fearfully and wonderfully made.
So I'm going to ask the apostle to be interpreted today. Hallelujah.
Amen.
That is what I'm going to do. There are certain things that God wants to do, which you have never seen with your eyes. You have never heard with your ears. You have never experienced. These things God is going to surely put them and perform them. I want to begin by greeting every visitor that we have. May God bless you. I know we have someone from England. I know we have someone who has come from Shawani. And all of you. And I want to also greet my wife. Apostle. And all the elders. Praise God. May you give Jesus a clap of
hands.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Then I also want to greet all our followers from England.
Croatia,
New Zealand,
Cyprus.
And right now, I don't know how God has done it. We have a huge following in Australia. I greet you in the name of Jesus Christ. May God bless you. May you give Jesus Christ another thunderous
table
for you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Tell your neighbor that God loves you. God loves you. Something, a miracle happened. Praise God. We were talking to our brother here and we were saying, you know how our ministry has been. I've been more of a televangelist than anything else. So I was more on social media. And we were not doing much on the ground. So I'm here to give this promise. That we are starting a new crusade. Hallelujah. We are now starting a new crusade. So I was shocked because one of my neighbors where we stay, you're saying there's a popular man of God. His name is Prophet Advocate Joshua, and he was telling me. I was saying, look, what is happening here? So we need to win souls to Christ. And that crusade has begun. That crusade has begun. So you are going to see a lot of change. And when we were talking to our brother here, I was saying, look, how much is it to buy some of these things that you have? And he said, I have got about other two speakers that I have. And you know what God does? One of my daughters in England. No, she's in Germany. She just sent me a message.
And sent it up, Tamba.
And said, Prophet, I've already sent $100.
$100.
So that we support the work of God. So already one is bought.
He says, you speak
and just now I was telling him that these things we are going to buy all of them. Praise the Lord. So it is by
the grace of God that such things happen. It is by the grace of God that such things happen. So we are going to be moving, getting into cities, preaching Jesus. So about Jesus Christ. I don't preach about any other man. There is a Jesus Christ to talk about. He lives.
Unorarama.
He is there.
Aripo.
And he shall forever remain living. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, it's all about Jesus. It's all about Jesus Christ. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So there is a part of scripture that I want you to read.
Yeah, don't put you.
Take out your Bible.
Tora Bible rako.
Tati neighbor, msat maneta kumira ere.
Msat maneta kumira ere.
Msat mchanya to mira.
So
we are in the book of John.
Chapter 20.
I want Apostle to read for me verse 29.
John chapter 20. Verse 29.
Yes. John chapter number 20, verse 29. Hallelujah. 20, verse 29. Tell your neighbor that today you are going to learn a gospel that you did not know.
John chapter 20.
Yes. Now you can sit down.
That's carried pass.
John chapter 20, verse 29.
John chapter 20, verse 29.
Yes.
Then Jesus told him, because you have seen me, you have believed. Blessed are those who have not seen and yet have believed.
Can you read it again?
Then Jesus told him, because you have seen me, you have believed. Blessed are those who have not seen and yet have believed.
Now, nyai, irikutanga Jesu, achitaura, nemuruma nonzi Thomas. Listen. I need to interpret. Muruma anonzi Jesu arutara ne muruma anonzi Thomas.
The man Jesus is speaking to the man Thomas.
Apostle is so good at interpreting. You will hear it very soon. So, Jesus Christ is saying to Thomas,
Jesu Christ unotikuna Thomas,
because you have seen me,
nekuda kwe kuti wandiona,
you have believed. Now, that becomes very startling. Shocking.
Shamisa.
Because we have got a verse where Jesus is saying, because you have seen me, you have believed. But I want to tell you a new gospel. He's talking to Thomas. That when it comes to blessings, it's never going to be about who has seen what or who has yet
what.
It is not going to be about what you have experienced or seen. It's going to be about your belief alone. Because Thomas' argument is simple. Thomas hears that Jesus Christ is resurrected.
Thomas, unonzwa kuti Jesu amutswa kuvakafa.
My God, my God, my God.
Mwari wangu, mwari wangu.
Thomas hears about the resurrection of Jesus Christ.
Thomas, unonzwa kumutsurudzwa kwa Jesu.
He goes to where the disciples are sitting.
Unosvika kune vadzidzi vakagara.
They tell him that Jesus Christ who died has resurrected.
Vomuudza kuti Jesu wakafa wamutswa.
And Thomas is saying, how can that be?
Thomas, unoti zvinoitika sei izvi?
You are telling me about the resurrection that I have not seen. You are telling me about a man that I did not see resurrect. I was never there when Jesus Christ came to you. You were only the 11 of you. I was not there. You were only the 10 of you in actual fact. Because Judas has already died. I did not see Jesus Christ myself. I need to see a sign. I want to see a sign. You can't tell me about Jesus who resurrected when I did not see the evidence that Jesus Christ is resurrected. I can't just hear about it. I need to see a sign. I need to see a sign. So the Bible says, the man Jesus appears to the disciples and he meets the disciples and he tells Thomas that, you know, if it comes to believing, if it comes to believing, when it comes to faith, evidence does not matter. You know, in law, and this is the title of my preaching, defeating the laws of evidence. Defeating the laws of evidence. In law, there is what they call evidence. So you are not guilty if there is no evidence. You are not guilty if there is no evidence. So it's not about whether or not you have committed the crime. It's not about whether or not you have raped the person. It's not about whether or not you have stolen the money. Do you have evidence that you have stolen the money? So you get into a court. All that they want to see is the evidence that you have stolen the money. Do you have witnesses to come and testify? Did anyone take a photo of you committing the crime? Is there CCTV footage that you stole the motor vehicle? So if you committed the crime, but there is no evidence, then you are free. Even if you raped him, but there is no evidence. Look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, you are not in law school. Look, it's about the evidence that is there. So Thomas, I can argue that he had met a lawyer. I can argue that he had a legal background. Because according to Thomas, you can't just come to me and tell me about a story that I never experienced. So Thomas is saying, I need the evidence.
Thomas,
you are saying Jesus resurrected. I need to see the evidence. So what does it say?
He
says that Thomas says to Jesus,
Thomas,
I need to see your hands. I need to see your face. I need to examine you. So Thomas becomes the first man who took Jesus into a physical inquiry about himself. So he says, I need the evidence. You can't just tell me about resurrection. Is it the real Jesus? So when Thomas is saying, I need to see your hands,
Thomas,
he needs to see the evidence that the man has wounds in his hands. And therefore he resurrected for sure. So Jesus Christ opens his hands. Shows Thomas the evidence that he is resurrected. Look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, you have to defeat the laws of evidence. Say, neighbor, you have to defeat the laws of evidence. In law, this law, what it says, it says that it is not real until and unless you see it. You can't just talk about a theft having been committed if you don't have the evidence that the theft has been committed. So, in other words, there can be evidence that someone has actually raped an individual, but they didn't. So it can happen in the converse. But the major thing you have to learn about is that the legal principle around it is that if there is no evidence, someone should be found not guilty. Yes. They should be found not guilty. The moment you realize that there is no evidence linking the person to the crime, they are not guilty. They are innocent. So you are exonerated on the basis of what people can see here. This is the legal principle that Thomas understood. So Thomas needed to inspect Jesus. Thomas needed to do, it is called an inspection in loco, at law. So he needed to inspect Jesus. He wanted to check his height. He wanted to check his physical stature. He needed to check the wounds. He needed to even check his smile to believe that Jesus Christ is resurrected. Ask your neighbor and say, neighbor, do you understand this thing? Say, neighbor, do you understand this thing? So Thomas is looking for evidence. Thomas is looking for evidence. In John 20:20, the Bible says that, and Jesus showed Thomas his hands. He did not deny. That, you know what, I need to show you my hands. He said, Thomas, you can see me. Thomas just doesn't need to see Jesus. He needs to see even his hands. There's a time that you can hear someone saying, this person committed the crime. And you get into court and there are about 5 witnesses testifying the same thing. But then still, the magistrate or the judge can demand further evidence. To say, I need further evidence. Do you have documentary proof? For example, in a rape trial, you can't just conclude the rape trial based on evidence from witnesses. When you are undertaking a rape trial, you need documentary evidence that proves penetration. Tell your neighbor that you have joined law school today. So what the magistrate is saying is that you cannot convict on evidence alone. Thomas seems to have gone to law school.
Thomas,
he tells Jesus Christ that I'm seeing you, but I need into hands. Because in his hands he's seeing a document which speaks about resurrection. I don't know if you're getting me what I'm saying here. So he said, I have seen you as a person, but I want to see your hands. I need to see somewhere where it is written that you are injured and you were beaten. And the document is the wound that appears in his hands.
Look
at your neighbor and say, neighbor, I need evidence. Say, neighbor, I need evidence. Where is the evidence? We are living in a generation that believes in evidence. We are living in a generation that believes when it sees. A generation that believes when it hears. This is the reason why you have got news. You have sent PC news. You have herald. You have got the times. Because we are in a generation that believes when it sees. But listen to what Jesus says. As long as you want a blessing, stop believing when you see. Stop believing when you hear. Stop believing when you experience it. Every individual, I want you to look at the person who is next to you right now. There are certain things that are fit for that person. And then there are things that appear not fit for that person. But they have those things. You see a person, you see an individual, I'm happy here that one of my daughters there came from England. She will tell you that when you get into an aeroplane, there are certain individuals that you will see who are not befitting of being in an aeroplane, but you find them sitting there. You find them sitting there. You actually wonder how they got there. But when you look at the evidence, I don't know if you're getting what I'm saying here. But when you look at the evidence, they are not fitting to be in that position. Meaning to say, the gospel according to Jesus ought to be true. There are people who are in marriage right now, but they are not befitting to be in that position. There are people right now who are driving, but they are not befitting to be there. There are people who are owning businesses right now, but they are not befitting to be there. There ought to be some evidence somewhere that you cannot see. So Jesus says to Thomas,
yes, Thomas,
when it comes to blessings, if it comes to blessings, if you want to get blessed, stop operating in that level. It is a lower level. It is a minimal level. It is a level of ignorance. If you want to get blessed, start to operate in another level. You ain't gonna believe in what you see, brother. You ain't gonna believe in what you hear, sister. You are going to see things that you can't see. So according to Jesus Christ, what should have happened? Thomas should just have heard about the resurrection of Jesus Christ and just believe.
Thomas, why
should just have believed. So Thomas insisted
Tomasi unaendelea mbele
on something
achitaura nizini
that was not in accordance to the gospel.
Having
walked with Jesus Christ all these years,
still
Thomas failed to understand the new gospel.
Thomas
he didn't understand this gospel. That if you want to get blessed, stop believing in what you see. Stop believing in what you hear. Just because there is evidence that there is something doesn't mean it exists. Are you getting what I'm saying? I told you and I said I have held trials where somebody is convicted but they never committed the crime. Because the devil is able to create evidence. Because the devil is able to create evidence. One of the strengths of the devil is in creating evidence. There is evidence that you are poor, but you are not poor. There is evidence that you are rejected, but you are not rejected. Jesus says, stop believing in what you see. You should have just believed before seeing. Because those who are led by the Spirit, they operate in the Spirit level. They move in the Spirit level. They move in the spiritual dimension. They don't believe when they see. So this is the gospel that Jesus Christ is giving to Thomas. Can you imagine? After I said to myself, after all these years having walked with Jesus, how did Thomas miss this?
Say Thomas was not going to miss this.
How did he miss it?
Say Agapotaba.
I remember it was last year.
I had
$1,000 in my pocket.
And
I said to my wife,
I'm
going to wait you.
She
said to me, look, how can you wait me when you have $1,000? Are you talking about $1,000 waiting?
And I said, it is enough. I
don't
believe it.
Because you have $20 in your pocket,
$20
it cannot disable you from doing something with a million. Don't believe in the evidence in your pocket. You look small, but you are not small. You look rejected, but you are not rejected. You look miserable, but you are not miserable. I'm preaching the gospel according to Jesus. Jesus Christ, do not believe in what you see. Whatever you see is able to deceive you. So I insisted. You need to believe in monies that you cannot see right now. You need to start to believe in monies that you cannot see right now. You need to believe in resources that you cannot see right now. By the time we waited, I last counted after having spent
30,000
on a wedding. And this is something that had been begun with $1,000 in the pocket.
$1,000
had an ability to flex its own muscles. And increase. Because there were monies we couldn't see at that time. Am I preaching something new to someone here? So Jesus Christ is saying to Thomas,
if
ever you are going to operate in the evidence dimension, if ever you are going to operate in the evidence dimension.
You
are going to forever remain defeated. Because you are going to wait for money to plan for a wedding. You are going to wait for money to plan to go and pay Lobola. You are going to wait for money to begin a business. I'm saying before December, someone has to have their business.
That is December, Satan.
I am saying before December, someone should have a tax shop.
That is December, Satan.
You cannot plan with money.
Because
money will follow an idea. Because the ability to see beyond what you have is God's heavenly authority. This is the authority that we have been blessed with. To do mighty things. To do exploits. Not operating and moving by what we see. But what we cannot see. I don't know if somebody is getting this. I spoke to a certain brethren. And they said, I'm calling you from Croatia. I always see you on social media. I've started businesses and they just go down. I no longer believe. I no longer believe that my business can rise. This is a man who was telling me that I was a multi-millionaire in 2009. But now, things have turned radically bad. And where I am now, it's less than a tenth of what I used to be. And I said, you need to reverse that word. That you no longer believe. That you no longer believe. If you are going to give up on yourself, things will give up on you. Businesses will give up on you. Authority will give up on you. I'm looking for men and women of authority. You are not like Thomas. Who believe in what they cannot see? Who believe in what they cannot see? I don't know if somebody is getting this. Look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, defeat the laws of evidence. Defeat the laws of evidence. Defeat the laws of evidence. All the problems that you are talking about is just evidence coming from the devil. It's just evidence coming from the devil. And the devil delights in evidence. There's a Bible verse. Let me take you to this Bible verse. There's a Bible verse which is saying, thou shalt not judge.
Iwe haikona kutonga.
Thou shalt not.
Iwe usatonge.
Thou shalt not judge.
Usatonge.
All of you have read that verse.
Mese makamere ngadimai.
Maybe more than 20 times, some of you.
Zishida kakawanda chaizo.
When I was reading it today,
the
Lord showed me a revelation.
Mwani wandirati za chisaruro.
He said, the reason why
zero.
I always insist
that
men ought not to judge. It's because judges operate on evidence.
Look at neighbor,
that revelation just missed you right now. I mean, God said it is because judges operate on evidence. The first thing that a judge will always look for. I'm happy that the apostle is an advocate. And he knows this thing. And we are going to convict him in church today. What these guys do, they always operate on evidence. If you are going to tell them about having bought a car, they want to see the car.
You're
going to tell them about marrying, they'll say, I want to see the wife. I'm looking for men who are going to get married before they get there. I don't know if you're getting
married.
I'm looking for people here who are going to wait before they wait.
You don't
get that. I'm looking for people here who are going to become millionaires before they arrive. Where is the evidence? I know. I know who I am. I am married in the name of Jesus. I am wicked in the name of Jesus. I am a millionaire in the name of Jesus. I am a great man of God in the name. Because just because there is evidence, it doesn't mean it exists. Just because there is evidence, it doesn't mean it exists. I'm looking for people who believe in what they can see. What they can see. What they can see. You know what we did? We said, I think, when I was in South Africa, I just made this resolution. And I said, God, I want to pay school fees for 2 children before November. And guess what? I did not have a piggy bank for that. I thought to myself, I need a piggy bank to start raising money for those children. But I said, no. God, I know. I know you. Find someone. Because it's not there in my pocket, it doesn't mean it doesn't exist. It ought to be somewhere that I can see. And this is exactly what I did. And you know what? By the time we got into Zimbabwe, within 4 days, I had heard one of the prominent leaders of this country calling me to get to their office. And
he
said, Prophet, we need to assist the church. But the first thing I'm going to do, go and choose 2 children in your church who are going to pay school fees. And I was like, okay, this is just what happened.
But
the time I told myself I'm going to do it, I did not have the money. Just because you are sick, it doesn't mean you are sick. The Bible says, let the sick say, I am healed. So that's defeat evidence. How can I say I am healed when I'm sick? How can I say that I am well when I'm unwell?
You
see the problem of
Thomas?
According to Thomas, if I have got TB in my body, it means I am sick. If I have got HIV in my body, according to Thomas, then I am sick. But according to Jesus, I can have a chronic disease, but I am not within the chronic disease. I can be in a bad economy, but the bad economy is not in me. I'm like Paul incarcerated, but they were not in incarceration themselves. They were not in incarceration themselves. They were just walls around them. But the walls were not within them. I thought you were going to say amen. So you ought to learn the art of defeating the laws of evidence. The laws of evidence, they are the most dangerous things that a Christian battles against. Because every day you have evidence. You have a house which is empty. You have a place which has nothing. You have a business that is struggling. You have skin that is having troubles. And now, right now, you have people who are rejecting you. But is that true? Is that true? So Jesus is saying you don't need to see it.
Yes, I could have fun and watch it.
I want you to read John 19, verse 30.
John 19, verse 30. Jesus did many other miracles, signs in the presence of his disciples, which are not recorded in this book. But these are written that you may believe that Jesus is the Christ, the Son of God, and that by believing you may have life in his name.
That verse introduces you to a lower level of the Spirit.
Do you know,
let me tell you something. If God had not known that people believe when they see, you would never have written the Bible. Let me tell you this. This verse that has just been read right now, what he is saying is that there are so many things which were done by Jesus which are not within these pages. So never think that this is all that Jesus did. That's what the verse is saying. Then he goes on to say,
when Ramberoti,
the reason why we have these verses and chapters is to ensure that those who do not believe stay. So it was only written because Jesus Christ and God and the Holy Spirit wanted someone to believe. Otherwise, if we had been a generation that just believes, a generation of faith, there was no need for the Bible. But he knew that just because there is a Thomas who manifested himself in the book of John, it is likely that we are going to have another Thomas today. You
don't
know, you can't tell me about a Jesus that I never saw. You can't tell me about a miracle that I never read. So they need to read it. But there is a higher level. There is a higher level of people who believe what they've never seen. They will get into an environment in the spirit where they know that this thing happened, even if they don't have
everything.
These are kingdom realities.
Izi ndozo kwadi
zeumambo. These are kingdom realities.
Ndozo kwadi zeumambo wa
Mwari. I want you to look at John 19:30.
Now to tarise John 19 verse 30.
Look at this.
Itarise.
This is one of the last verses that I'm going to give to you.
Do imwe ntima dzokupensera dzachakupa nashi.
John 19:30.
John 19 verse 30.
I want you to read that.
John 19 verse 30.
Look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, this gospel, that is preaching about will fix the economy of Zimbabwe. Say, neighbor, if you are looking for a solution to the economy, listen to this gospel. It will fix the economy of Zimbabwe. Can you read that?
John 19, verse 30. When he had received the drink, Jesus said, "It is finished." With that, he bowed his head and gave up his spirit.
Did you hear that?
Was it where it is?
So the Bible says that and Jesus Christ died.
Shogoro kuti Jesu wakabva wafa.
But before he died,
asi usati wafa.
Everyone following us from whichever country, listen to this part.
Wesari kuti tera kune dzimwe nyika, terera panyaya iyi.
I'm saying that after Jesus Christ,
ndikuti Jesu mushure mekunge,
He had been beaten.
Aroa.
He's taken to the cross. And the Bible says, Jesus Christ, just before he died, he said, it is finished. Tell your neighbor, it is finished. I'm preaching about defeating the laws of evidence. In law, there is what is called the hearsay evidence rule. So what they do, they are saying, you can't come to court and tell us that so and so said this. That person has to come to court and speak for himself. So that is the hearsay rule.
So
in other words, you can't come to court to talk about what someone else talked about. They actually have what is called the Civil Evidence Act. And in that act, they have a rule which says you can't come to court to say, Prophet Advocate Joshua said this. What they say is that prophet himself should come to court and speak for himself. So that is the evidence rule. So as a general rule, that evidence is inadmissible. But there's an author called Shrikant.
As it put in your annons, Shrikant.
He speaks about, he wrote a book, I think, for about 400 pages. He speaks about an exception to the ESA evidence rule.
Anon Taura and Shimash, I eat quite as you.
So he says,
Anovati,
if someone goes to court,
Kanamun Akaenda Kudari,
talking about what someone else said, that person should have died. So you can go to court and say that I was there at her deathbed. Before he died, he said that my car belongs to my last
brother.
And then they will say, there's an evidence rule. You say, no, he said it before he died. So in other words, at law you are allowed to go to court talking about what a dead person said before they die. Tell your neighbor that this revelation will destroy your lungs. Because what they are saying is that, you know what? All you people, you have a certain level that you will get to. If you are sick, do you know that there are people that I preached to? The gospel.
Shoko.
Told them that you have to follow me so that we preach the gospel. Some of them at that time, they were ministers. Some of them, they were mayors at that time. You go to him, you tell him that you have to follow me so that we preach the gospel. But because they are still fit, they will never leave you. They will put their hands in their pockets. Say, you know what, prophet, this is $100. You can take this money. You will never see them coming for a service. You will never see them wanting to work for God. Because things are well. The same people, the day they become sick and they are admitted at Avenue's hospital, I'm the first person that the secretary calls to say, come and pray for you. And that person now wants to get born again on the deathbed. Meaning to say, human is this thing is proven in science. In biology, there is a rule that they have. This biological rule says there is a certain level of genuinity that a human being gets to when they are sick. Or when they are almost
there's
a scholar who says that every person before you die
usatuafa.
10 minutes before you die.
Kwa sara kwa shoma shoma ukichifa.
You already know.
Nengo agusisi.
You have ever seen a person die? You know
what I mean. Kadoka mbona muna chifa unozia sonduta ores.
10 minutes before a person dies, they already know. And for some of them, this will be the first time for them prophesying. Before they die. So according to the hearsay rule, which gives an exception, it is called a dying declaration. Dying declarations are admissible as yes, because there's a level of genuinity that every individual gets before they die. So the court knows that every person, when they're about to die, they will tell the truth. They know if in a liar before they die, they will tell the truth. Or when they are sick, they will tell the truth. So they will say, come with the evidence of a person who was about to die. So they will only allow hearsay evidence to that extent.
Tabira chete manzwira nzwira kana ataulwa ni muna akufa.
Am I talking to somebody at all?
Pana ndukta wana yeri panapa.
Am I talking to somebody at all?
Pana ndukta wana yeri panapa.
A person will say to you,
Mono, ano taura kwa uri?
Where is the evidence that you have got Jesus in your life?
Kote uri pi umbo wekutu na Jesu mupenye wako.
Where is the evidence that you have Jesus in your life?
Uri pi umbo wekutu na Jesu mupenye wako.
The first thing I will say, is that I might not have evidence, but Jesus is in my life. Say, you say you walk with God. Why is the God to walk with you? Sorry, I don't need evidence to say that I'm walking with God. I don't need evidence to for you to see that I'm walking with him. The Bible records that the man Enoch walked with God. Without, there was no selfie to testify that Enoch walked with God. No, you missed this. There's not even a single Bible verse which has a selfie of God and Enoch walking together. But we have a verse saying the man Enoch walked with God. Where did they get that? There's no evidence, but the man walked with God. There's no evidence, but the man was God's friend. I need evidence for me to prove that I walked with God. It just says that the man walked with God.
Sina mwanzi murume wakafamba na mari.
He walked with him.
Wakafamba na jina mari.
But there is no selfie.
Asi akuna selfie.
There is no picture to prove that truly Enoch walked with God.
Akuna mufana nizo unozirati.
The testimony of Enoch was difficult to be accepted in the society.
Kupupura kwa Enoch kwa isa tabirika munara
unda. Because society on the evidence. But my God is not a physical personality. So they want to see a God walking, but they can't see him. But I'm walking with him. So the first thing I'll say is I don't need evidence that Jesus is in my life. I don't need evidence. I'm defeating the laws of evidence. Tell you what. I'm repenting today. There's a kind of gospel that I used to believe in. That, you know what? If someone is walking with God, they need to have a car. They need to have money in their pocket. Look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, you didn't hear this. There is a type of gospel which I used to believe. You don't need $200 US dollars worth of Brazilian for you to prove that and you're walking with God.
As it tumbled, Brazil in 200,
you don't need a motor vehicle to prove that you're walking with God. You don't need a beautiful suit to show that you're walking with God. I don't need judge you a money trouser to show that I'm walking with God. I don't need Versace shoes to show that I'm walking with God. I don't need the latest Mercedes to show that I'm walking with God. I'm defeating the evidence. I don't need to be educated to be walking with God. The Bible says that Peter was so uneducated that he smelled of being uneducated. Like there was a smell of Peter being uneducated. So you don't need an LLB degree to be walking with God. You don't need to be rich to prove that you are walking with God. That's a wrong gospel. And I repent.
Yes.
Just because it makes sense and it is preached by many people, it doesn't make it true.
Kana zvitambirika nenjere dzedu zvaparidzwa nevazhinji asiri kuti chokwadi.
A man can be quiet, be a friend of God.
Rume unogona kuve murombo asari shamwari
yaMwari. A man can be sick but yet be a friend of God.
Munhu anogona kunge achirwara asari shamwari yaMwari.
So the first thing I will say, I don't need evidence. But I'm walking with him. I don't need evidence. But I'm walking with him. I don't need evidence. But I'm walking with Jesus. I don't need evidence. But I'm walking with God. I don't need evidence. But I'm walking with Jehovah. The second thing I will say is that Jesus Christ before he died, they'll say, you want to tell us about what Matthew wrote about? You want to tell us about what John wrote about? You want to tell us about what Isaiah wrote about? You are not Isaiah. Let Isaiah come to tell us.
Because
there is a yes and evidence rule. But I'll tell them something. There is a verse that he just read about. Jesus before he died. His last words. It is finished. He said it is finished. He said it is finished. He means he is present in my life is there. I am no longer isolated from God. I am no longer isolated from Jesus. I am no longer isolated from the Holy Spirit. Jesus said it is finished. These are the ways that Jesus Christ talked about before he died. So I can go with those words to God. I don't know if somebody's getting what I'm saying here. Before Jesus died, the last words he spoke about, he said it is finished. It is finished. It is finished. It is finished. There ought to be something that he understood. There ought to be something that he had seen. And I can stand before any man. I can stand before any man and declare that I don't have evidence, but I know. Because Jesus said, it is finished. The man said it before he died. Even if you say that my Jesus was lying, he could not have lied before his death. No. There is no way he could have lied before. Jesus is my banner of belief. The message of the cross is my banner of belief. I ain't gonna allow someone to make me doubt. I ain't gonna allow someone to tell me I'm not a millionaire. I ain't gonna allow someone to tell me that I'm poor. Because he said I am, it is finished. I ain't gonna allow someone to tell me that I cannot do it. Because he said it is finished. I am defeating the laws of evidence. I am to not pass on evidence. I do not rely on evidence. I do not rely on what I can see. I do not rely on what I can see. I am from a poor background, but I'm carrying it to a rich generation because he said that it is finished.
So the man says it is finished.
Jesus,
so even if you wanted to doubt him,
his
words on the cross,
they
are admissible in court.
So even if you are
going to go to the court of
heaven,
where God is the judge, you get there, you are standing it as a witness. You say, no, I am entitled to heaven because Jesus saved me. There is a man called Satan. He goes before God, the judge. He says, this one is a sinner. He can't enter heaven. But there is a God who understands that because Satan is appeared with evidence, that does not make it true. I'm preaching to someone who sinned here, but I'm here to preach to you. You are not a sinner. You didn't hear this. We are getting to the good news level. Just because there is evidence that you sinned doesn't make you a sinner. This is the message of Jesus. And we are in a generation that has failed to understand that gospel. Advocate Jesus will appear in the court of heaven.
Advocate Jesus
and say, I was there on the cross and I declared that it is finished. I also declared whoever will confess me as their personal Lord and Savior shall see heaven, not by their own works, not by their own authority, not by their own pockets, not by the money they have, not by the cars they bought on them, not by the way they walk, but by my grace. You could not enter heaven if Jesus Christ had not been there. So what does God and Jesus Christ do here? So Jesus makes submissions. He makes submissions before God. He argues for you. The kingdom of God is based on the court setup. You have Jesus as the advocate. God is the judge. You have got Satan as the prosecutor.
Satan is
I know someone doesn't like a PP here. So Satan goes before God with evidence. On this day he sins. On this day he did this. But the submission of Jesus,
stop
looking at the evidence. Stop looking at the evidence. There is a cross which speaks for them. Even though there is evidence,
There is a cross which speaks for them. There is salvation which speaks for them. I wish someone would see the need to get to the level where we defeat the evidence. You need to graduate to a point where you no longer believe in what you see. You don't need money to register a company. You don't need money to do things. You need to see what is not there. You need to see what you can't see. Look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, I'm about to defeat the evidence. For some of you, if we ask you, who is a prophet?
Profita chi?
You will say that a prophet is a man who prophesies.
Not him profita. Murume uno profita.
Ask your neighbor, who is a prophet?
Bom vunza kuti profita. Muna gaita se.
Someone will say, a prophet is someone who can prophesy.
Mungono tim profita, muna no profita.
If they said a prophet is a man who prophesied, tell them go and get born again.
Kana aku pindura kuti profita amuna ano profita muzo inano tendeuka. Pacha.
Do you hear me?
Who's in there?
No.
What?
The man Abraham, the Bible records Genesis 20. It says that Abraham, a prophet of God, but there is no face of his prophet.
Abraham anonzi mu profita mu Bible asati paone pa ano profita.
So where did this prophetic come from?
Saka chiprofita chaka vipi?
The book of Joel says in the last days your young men are going to prophesy. It doesn't call them prophets.
Zvinonzi vana vechidiki vachaprofita asi havanzi maprofita.
Did the Bible say they are prophets?
Saka ndiri nebhaibheri maprofita.
What does it mean?
Zvinorevei.
A prophet,
muprofita,
is a man,
munhu,
who has received an anointing and a calling from God.
Of the prophet.
So even if he doesn't prophesy, that does not mean he's not a prophet. So tell you what, right now we have got pastors who are masquerading in the name of the prophet. Because you have made a prophecy doesn't make you a prophet. I don't know if you're hearing what I'm saying. So you can be an evangelist. Let me tell you something. If we say a medical doctor is someone who heals people. If I'm going to pray for you here, being a lawyer that I am, and you get healed, I'm not a doctor.
Alright,
let me put it to the person. Look at the person next to you. The person next to you. What the Bible is saying. If they steal today, doesn't make them a thief. That is the gospel of Jesus. Say, neighbor, welcome to good news. Are you hearing what I'm saying? I had more than 100 calls yesterday. People all over the world. I used to doubt you. The other one said, I used to doubt you. That one said they're a minister in Sudan or somewhere. I don't know.
Makati, diri guru kota reku Sudan.
Someone from England used to share to me your prophecies.
Makanza mwe mnari ku England, I diratiza za my profita.
I used to doubt you.
Makanzi daisa zvitora nemazvo.
But when that person sent me your prophecies about Robert Mugabe.
Aspaka zo this tumira muchiprofita chei cha Robert Mugabe.
On Friday.
Usoichishana.
I said, this man is a prophet. I told them, you are wrong.
How about you? I'm religious.
You don't believe in a prophet because he has prophesied.
I would tell them.
So he went on and on, and the prophecy is too detailed. And you spoke about that there's going to be a death before 24 November 2019. Well, that, so, I now believe, men of God, can you just pray for me? Anoint me. And I was like, you are wrong.
Wakati chiprofita cha mapa chine udzamu wakanyanya. Saka daku kutenda indakatai wa munga zutende ne kutimaona chiprofita.
You don't believe based on the evidence you have seen.
Haufana kutenda kulikita ne umbo
waona. If other people are going to get into a point of spiritual maturity,
kana wale wale kuzokura pamwea,
they are going to believe
wale kuzofanira kuti vatende
in what they have not seen. What they have not yet. Do not judge the person who is next to you based on what you see now.
I'm
telling you this. Do not judge the person next to you based on what you see now. This man or woman that you see beside you, they belong to a special God. They belong to a special God. I'm talking about special God. The God of
Jacob.
Abraham.
Isaac.
Elijah. Not some of these other gods you hear in
China.
A daughter of mine called me last week and said, Papa, you know what? In China here, we are not allowed to worship. And I was like, okay.
Said, if
someone is to hear you talking about Jesus, you will lose your job. 99% of China, they are Buddhists. And it's a god in that area.
Atorichimwari chenzvimbo iyoyo.
But I'm saying,
asindirikuti,
if ever you are going to see a man,
kana kuzoona munhu,
the person next to you,
ari patiri wako,
believing in this god,
achitenda muna mwari uyu,
the god of the Bible,
mwari akanyorwa Bible,
never judge them based on what you are seeing.
Haikona kumutonga kubudikidza nezvauri kuona iwe.
Because just because you see evidence that tomorrow they are going to be poor, it doesn't make them poor. I'm telling you, there's a day you will knock at their door looking for a job. And you wonder, is that that person? You say 2019 hours with that person. I was sitting with them in that gazebo. And we were in that gazebo. Sitting with that person. And people will say you are lying because there is no evidence that you are with them. They will say, what happened to you? Because they believe in evidence. Ask your neighbor, say, neighbor, do you understand this whole thing about evidence? We want to defeat evidence today. Evidence has to be defeated. You believe too much in what you see. Start believing in what you can't see. Start believing in what you can't hear. There's evidence that your generation is cursed, but you are not cursed.
Makadia
song.
Yes.
I want to pray with someone today. Who is saying I'm tired of the evidence? I'm tired of the evidence. I'm now getting into another realm. Where I defeat
everything.
Are you ready at all? I want you to get on your feet. La pradus ijata la hai. And as we make this prayer, acknowledge the man of God in our midst. Praise God. Prophet Joel.
Profeta Joel.
As I make this prayer,
I
acknowledge every servant of God in this house now. Because I know that if we agree on this thing, I'm telling you, exploits will come up this prayer. Just because I am sick, it doesn't make me sick. Just because there is evidence that I'm poor, it doesn't ensure that I don't have a business in the future. I know what I'm talking about. I know what I'm talking about. Things are not well, but the unwellness is not within me. Because I
know.
Someone here used to be listed on the London Stock Exchange. I'm telling you. Someone somewhere here has to be listed. Because it's not there, it doesn't make it absent. It's there somewhere. Just because your pocket is dry, it doesn't make you dry. Money is coming.
Hallelujah.
You know, a lot of times, when you think about what God does, the first thing that gets into your mind is the inexplicable nature of what He does. What does it mean? It means somehow, somewhere, there is everything that you would hope for somewhere. And if you can't see them, there's evidence that it is there. I'm looking for someone who is ready to pray. I'm not looking for someone who is ready to dance. I'm looking for someone who is ready to pray unto the living God. To say, God, I am moving away from the evidence. I'm now being transformed to another dimension. Are you ready to pray? You know, I need you to connect to this prayer. I need you to get overwhelmed in this prayer. Where you're saying, God, I'm tired of being in evidence. The devil operates with evidence. Are you ready for this? I want you to lift up your right hand. Lift up those holy hands unto you. Say, my Lord, in the name of Jesus.
My Lord, in the name of Jesus.
Say, my Lord, in the name of Jesus.
My Lord, in the name of Jesus.
I am praying today.
I am praying today.
I am praying today.
I am praying today.
I am tired of the evidence.
I am tired of the evidence.
I speak against evidence.
I speak against evidence.
I defeat the evidence.
I defeat the evidence.